every year, Games Day is the day when a whole year of effort comes together, where teams present their games to, first of all, academics here in computer science, but also to the wider public and to other people from the university. This year we have 11 games. They really cover the full range from games for a single person to games where you have dozens and dozens of people playing each other.
So to create a game, you kind of have to start from the bottom up and think about what people will want, what you would enjoy in a game, something that hasn't been done before, which is what we were trying to go for.
We've done a lot of CS work throughout the past 3 years, but this was much more than just CS. We worked with composers, we worked with artists, we learned to manage big teams. We had like 2,400 hours of effort in total in this game. It feels like being a real company, even though you're still in uni.
It's very different because it's a very creative project. Previously, normally you have a very specific target you have to do. This project you have to like combine all your different skills, so you need creativity and you need problem solving and teamwork, as well as a combination of all your different things you've learned in the course.
How to go about structuring and designing a really large project, how to interact and work with people, particularly in software development, so interacting with team members, the necessities when it comes to managing a project, making sure the project goes well. Our composer does the film and TV course here at Bristol. He specialises in ambient music. I think it's excellent and it really adds a lot to our game.
Making sure everything was integrated properly, making sure everything worked together. We've got 5 separate screens, 3 servers, making sure that everything worked together and making sure if one bit did break, then the rest didn't crash entirely as well.
We found that the game engines weren't giving us enough control, so we developed everything from scratch, from the ground up, something like 13,000 lines of code and many, many hours of work.
Every group has different areas of expertise and things that they're specialised in throughout the day. Ours in particular is obviously our AI, which we've implemented using a neural network. It's a real opportunity for other developers to come and see the different kind of modern technologies that the new programmers of tomorrow are using.
We have a murder mystery game. The idea is that it's played on Android phones using Google Cardboard. Only one person will be the murderer and all of them have to try and figure out who the murderer is.
I'd say it's kind of completely different to anything we've ever done before. There's structure to it, but it's not like do this here, this then, this then. You kind of organise the whole thing yourselves and as a team you have to like get behind it, so it's much more like a real world application.
Having led the team as well as seen the challenges and struggles, I think it really builds you as a person, it really teaches you skills which are really transferable. This is actually one of the reasons I picked Bristol, because they have the games working, a lot of other unis don't.
It's really nice to see what is actually achievable by uni students in the space of a year. It's definitely a really fun atmosphere on the day as well.
Building a game in its own right is an immense opportunity to produce something which will carry you possibly further than a specific lecture series could. So it's an experience for students that they can take out of their studies for, years to come.